Okay, as it turns out, you know, on this database thing, what was going on is in debug mode or whatever. I mean, I'm not even sure if this is, you know, I mean, I found the answer to it in this article here, but, you know, basically I had to switch this property here, you know, by selecting the database file and change it to copy if newer, so as opposed to copy always. And now you can. Update the file. As you see, I've already added some data here. Anyway, so got that many records, and I can close out, and of course, just like last time, I can bring it back up, and you can see the data is still there, but the difference is that now I can close it, and actually rerun it, and our data is there, so it's working now, so that was really the problem. So, pretty nifty. Went ahead and moved this to where it's a tab, so I got my full length box back. We've got your data sources there now, if you want to view it. But, you know, but you can actually access this employee data set, you know, so there are some methods and properties to it, as well as this table manager. This is code that was automatically added in, so this is the code for the save button and, you know, for the form load event, which populates the table. So, but, you know, this data set, you can work with it as an object. So, for example, I can, let's say, I think it's from here, you know, employee data set dot, you know, tables dot, you know, I can add a table or whatever. I don't know if you can access a table specifically or not. But anyway, you know, you do have a lot of these types of types of methods. So, I mean, I don't see any access to the table directly, but I'm sure you can somewhere in here. I don't see any reference to any of the fields, but at any rate, you know, the point is that, you know, that's kind of what that data set did, you know, this thing here that, you know, basically gives you an object to access elements of the database. So anyway,